So welcome along. My name's Ski Oakenfull, and I'm going to be doing a deconstruction of this track by Jamiroquai. And just kind of picking up from the discussion earlier, where talking about kind of individuality and finding your own voice, I think this is a great example of an electronic track that actually draws upon a lot of influences and is a great pop track as well as being pretty innovative as well. So we're going to have a look at it. It was produced by Matt Johnson and JK. Matt Johnson is the keyboard player. He's been with in Jamiroquai for quite a while, over 10 years. It's from the album, Automaton, and it was released at the start of this year on 27th of January, came out on Virgin EMI. It was recorded at Chillington Studios, which is JK's studio. You can see a little picture there. So that is actually, I've been there actually, that's actually his studio. He's got a lovely collection of cars. He's always having a laugh on that one. Just talking about the styles, there's disco influence, electro, funk, synth pop, and even a bit of a rap section as well. And as far as comparisons, it's been compared to Daft Punk, even the 1982 Tron soundtrack, and Africa Bambaataa as well. So I think the first thing to do is just listen to the track. Have you heard the track? Is it a familiar track to you, everyone? Good. Okay, well, if not, then let's have a listen to it. As you can hear, it's a very synth-heavy track. I know that Matt is very fond of his analog synths. For me, one of the key sounds is this bass line sound that happens in the verse, which I'm pretty sure is a mini Moog or a recreation of a mini Moog. Mini Moog was a classic synth, Model D, came out in the early 70s, actually recently been remade as well. And I'm going to be using Native Instruments Monarch, which is modeled on the same architecture as mini Moog. So I'm going to be using that to try to recreate the bass line. I just want to have a quick talk about what a deconstruction is. It's basically where we take apart the elements of a track to understand them. And we use it as an educational tool to teach music theory and production techniques. I mean, I started out as a keyboard player, and I just wanted to learn other people's music. I wanted to kind of figure out chords and bass lines and things just to kind of understand them. Not because I wanted to particularly copy them, but just so I could actually get inside the music and try to figure out what was going on. So at Point Blank, we use well-known electronic tracks to illustrate these various aspects of music composition. So we look at key, scales, chords, bass lines, and structure. And it's a very immediate and practical process, and the students don't have to get too bogged down in practicing scales. So we're not kind of giving them lots of scale charts and they've got to sit down there for ages. It's contextualizing music theory in the kind of music that they want to be playing, where they want to be making. I think most importantly is the students get to use their ears to apply the theory and techniques to their own music. As we've been talking, it's all about finding your own voice and applying that to your own music. I wrote a course called Electronic Music Composition, which features all these deconstructions, and that actually appears in our degree program now, in our music composition module. Let's get stuck in. One of the key features of this track is the arpeggio, and this is where, rather than just playing, I'll just get a piano sound here, hold on. So rather than just holding down a chord like this, it's when we play the notes in a rhythmic sequence. So that's the chord, an arpeggio would be like this. It's a very sort of classical sound, but it's used so much in electronic music. I'm sure you're going to be very familiar with it. Another fun fact, the arpeggio comes from the Italian word arpeggiare, which means to play on a harp. Let's get into this. I'm using Ableton Live together with Push, and we're going to be using Session View here. So this is the feature, really, of Ableton Live, where you have the arrange view, where you kind of arrange your track in a linear format. But this is Session View, where you have clips, and you can just create lots of loops that work together. But you can also have scenes as well. So you can actually build up your arrangement in scenes, which are groups of these clips. So that's how we're going to put it together. Let's just start off with this first section. We're going to be looking at three sections of the track. There's this verse section with intro and the verse, then the chorus section, which is the more traditional Jamiroquai funky kind of sound, and then there's a middle kind of electro rap section as well. Let's kick off with the introduction section. So, hopefully you can see my keyboard here. Now, let's just have a quick talk about the key signature. Most modern music has a tonal center or a key, and the key is defined by the notes of the scale. So very, very simply, C major features those notes. And then if we go to a minor scale, a major scale has kind of more of a happy, upbeat sound. A minor scale, like A minor, has a sadder sound. What's amazing about this track is it's actually quite hard to define one single key. I would actually say that it's got two keys, F sharp minor and G sharp minor. So F sharp minor features three sharps. And then G sharp minor's got five sharps. Now they're a tone apart, these scales, but we kind of shift between, they shift between the two different keys. Let's just look at this first part here. So the first chord is F sharp minor, then it goes to E major. So at this point we're in F sharp, but then it goes to G sharp minor, and then D sharp minor. So they're the four chords of this intro section. So let's put them in. Let's put the metronome on. Okay, lose this for the moment, and make sure that the quantize is on as well. Yep, here we go. There we go. So a little mistake there. Let's just get rid of that. So there we go. We got our first part there. Let's get rid of this horrible metronome sound. So now we're going to build this up, and there's actually another arpeggio sound that comes over that. So I'm just going to copy that down to the next scene. And also just a quick word to say that this sound that I'm using here is the an analog device in Ableton. And it's using two oscillators, and they're actually tuned an octave apart from each other, or two octaves apart from each other, which gives it that kind of really fat sound. That's the first oscillator. There you go, and that's the second oscillator. So together they've got a really kind of fat sound. So if we go over to the next sound, now this is the same thing, but it just goes alongside with that. So if I just play that now, and let's use another method of putting an arpeggio in. And Ableton Live is great because it's got an arpeggio device. If you just go to the MIDI effects here and just drag over the arpeggiator. Let's focus in on that so we can actually see what's going on. So we've got the rate control here at the moment. And at the moment, it's set to eighth notes. But if we set that to 16th notes, there we go. And then hold down the chord. So let's just bring up the keyboard again. There we go. So we can actually record that in. So let's. There we go. So you can hear that actually the start point sometimes was messing up a little bit. So we might have to go and fix that. But let's have a listen to how that sounds. So sometimes you just need to lengthen those notes just to make sure that the trigger point works okay. So let's just lengthen those out a bit. I'm just going to copy that clip down here so it's at the right scene. There we go. So we've got our introduction. Another thing that features on this sound is the use of delay. Now, what I've got is a ping pong delay set up on a return here. And if I just dial that in on this first sound, you can hear what a difference that makes. So it's going from side to side, so it gives it some stereo width. And also, because there's a kind of hangover of the notes, it's actually contributing to the chord. It's kind of building up the chord within that arpeggio. So I can add that to this sound as well. Two of them together. Great, so we've got our introduction sound. Let's go to the verse section. And for this, we're going to program a beat. That's going to be our starting point. And I've just got a Linn drum here. This is a battery Linn drum, and I've got it incorporated into a drum rack. I'm not sure if they actually use this drum sound, but I don't want to focus too much on that. It's more just kind of getting the part together. Let's just put the metronome back on again. Now I'm going to use, for the hi-hat, I'm going to use the repeat function on push, which means I can just hold down the note, and it's just going to play 16th hi-hats for me. There we go. So we've got our basic beat, and just a quick word about what I've got on here, effects-wise. I've got this really lovely EQ, this is a free plugin, Lufticus. And this is kind of adding a bit of bottom end at 40 hertz and a bit of high end as well, just to brighten it up a little bit. Without it, sounds like this. Really kind of gives it some life. And I'm also using the LA2A UAD plugin, just to kind of fatten up the sound, give it some compression. If I take that off, sounds a bit flat. Put that on, really kind of gives it some energy. And I think the next thing we should put in is a crash. Every track needs a crash. And I'm just going to take the loop off that so it only triggers. When I trigger that scene, it only happens once. There we go. Now we're going to get into the really fun bit, which is the bass line. And as I mentioned before, I'm going to use the Monarch for this. It's based on the Mini Moog architecture. So this is the sound. So it's a lovely fat sound. I've got a bit of delay on this as well, ping pong delay. So this has got three oscillators, this synth, and they're tuned in various octaves apart from each other. So if we listen to the first oscillator, this is a square wave here, and that's at 32, that octave. If I bring in the next one, that's an octave up at 16, and that is a a saw wave there. And then this one here is a two octaves up from that. So the three oscillators together create this really kind of fat sound. So that's the sound. Let's have a look at the actual chord sequence. Now for this, you can see it's going on the F sharp, then it goes to D minor, and these are chords that are being implied by the bass line. So next one is going to G sharp minor, and then going to B minor. And the other thing that's interesting is with that is that rather than just each bar staying on that chord, like that, it's actually arriving at the next chord just before. So we've got the F sharp here, and then it's starting to play notes from the D minor. Let's just bring up the keyboard so you can see what I'm doing. So let's put that in. I'm going to actually lower the tempo a little bit. Let's make sure the auto quantize is on. There we go. So let's put that in. There we go, made it. And then we can put the tempo back up again. So we've got our verse section. Pretty simple, basically just a beat and the bass line with that crash in there as well. So let's move on to the chorus section. And as I said, this is where it kind of gets into sort of more traditional Jamiroquai territory, a bit more funky. This is where a live electric bass comes in. Also, I've got a kind of more of a traditional beat, like drum kit beat. So let's put that in. There we go. Now, the chords, they pick up from the intro section, but they're actually kind of slightly extended. We can actually put those chords back in again using the arpeggiator. Basically, the first half is the same. So F sharp minor, E major, G sharp minor, D sharp minor. Then it goes F sharp minor again, E major, G sharp minor, then it goes to B major. So let's put that in. There we go. Now we're going to put the bass line in, and this is where we can all practice our air bass. And this bass line is following those chords of the arpeggio, so let's put that in. There we go. So let's continue with that. Just a little note actually on what sound I'm using. That is a contact sound. It's a Scarby bass. There we go. Really love this. Love all the Scarby stuff. And again, I'm using the LA-2A on this just to kind of even out that sound. Next thing to put in is a pad sound. So these are the same chords, but they're just slightly extending. So just bring up the keyboard again. There we go. So we've got our F sharp minor. So it's playing all the notes of this triad, including this one. But for this section, we actually play the third or the second degree of that chord as well. So in the right hand, it's actually the second inversion, but it's thickened out by playing all the notes. So let's put that in. Now, if you go and listen to the track, there is a feature of this section which is a very popular technique in dance music. I'm sure you'll be very familiar with it, and certainly a lot of students at Point Blank want to learn it before they even learn anything else, and that is sidechain compression. So for this, that's when you have this kind of ducking, sucking effect, and it's used so much, especially on these kind of pad chords. If I just play to you what it sounds like, you'll know what I'm talking about. So in order to achieve that, I've got a compressor over those pads there. If I just zoom in, there we go. And you can see I've got sidechain turned on, and it's taking the audio from a TR-909 kit that I've got set up. So if I just actually play that, bring that into the mix, if I put that on, so if I now take that out of the mix, you can hear it's working to actually duck that on wherever those kick drums come. Bring in the arpeggio. Bring the crash on there as well. So we've built up four scenes. We've got this one. This is our introduction. It's where we build on that introduction. We've got our verse section. We've got our chorus section. Right. Let's move on to the middle, or not, yeah, sort of the middle section. It's like the rap electro section. And for this, we're going to go back to that Michael Jackson beat. Here we go. Where is it? There we go. And let's put that in. And underneath that, I'm going to put some of this Lindrum. There's a new bass line that comes in here, and this is where we're kind of going into the G sharp minor section. So before we've been starting on the F sharp, this is where we go into the G sharp minor section. So I'm using Monarch again for this. Slightly different sound. And what's different about this sound is that the second oscillator here is playing a major third up. So let's play that. Put it in. You also notice we've got this glide here, also known as portamento. So that's kind of moving up, sliding up to the next note. So we've got that. Now, I'm going to duplicate that because there's also some guitar that comes in. Now, for this, unfortunately, I couldn't get a guitarist in, but so I turned to the Native Instruments Contact again. And again, Scarby, I've got this great plugin, these great sounds. It's the Scarby Funk guitarist. And I used the 70s Disco Party, because it is a disco track. So what I actually did with that is I bounced that down, and actually bounced that down to audio, so I could then put some effects on that. I just wanted to make sure. It was a bit difficult to determine where that part started. So I'm just going to drag that over to an audio track here. And I also used the guitar rig to make it sound like it's like a proper guitar going through an amp. You can really hear the difference, actually, if I take that off. And let's listen to it with everything. We've got the different sections now, and one thing that I love to do when with these deconstructions is actually get the a cappella. I'm actually going to add those in now. I've got an audio track here, and I'm just going to drag those over. Verse section, chorus section. So let's just give you, I'll just solo it just so you can hear how great they sound. Every heart is beating. I'm all love. Can't you feel me feeling? Take my hand. Going like a junkie. So I think now we should just have a listen through to those different sections. I'm just going to trigger them from push. And remember, we're still in session view here. We haven't even put it into the arrangement, but we can actually arrange it on the fly. That's the great thing about session view. So let's just start off with the intro and play through it. Section. There we have it. There's Automaton. I hope you enjoyed that. Thanks a lot. Cheers.
Override it, got a million ways to synthesize.